In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, amen.
Happy Baskha. كل سنة وانتم طيبين. Today is the Holy Tuesday of the Baskha, and it's actually the day that consumed most. I thought I'm loud enough. People at work tell me loud and I'm too loud. Anyway. Okay. So if you look at every day in the Pascha, we read multiple chapters, right? So Tuesday of Pascha consumes the most out of any day of all Paschas, even, believe me, including Gumaa al-Azima, Good Friday. So أكتر يوم بنقرا فيه رايات أو أكتر يوم ممثل في الإنجيل أو في الأربع أناجيل هو يوم التلات. التلات المسيح اتكلم فيه عن المجيء الثاني، واتكلم فيه عن العلامات القيامة، واتكلم فيه عن الملكوت، وينهيه بجملة حزينة قوي. So question in English. So Tuesday, Jesus talked about the second coming, the signs that will tell us the second coming, the heavenly kingdom, talked in parables, اتكلم بأمثال كتيرة قوي. It ended, we just read it a second ago, in a very sad sentence. Anyone remembers? Pay attention, I'm going to ask questions. Anyone remembers what was the very last sentence of the 11th hour, don't cheat. Sharif, I see you. The very last sentence in the 11th hour of the gospel. I have to go a little bit fast, عشان we can cover a little bit more. Excellent. If anyone finds him, we need to hand him off. إذا وجده أحد أرادوا أن يمسكوه. After all what he has done, so the plot started today. بالعربي عملت لكم ملخص جميل كده وسريع على الأيام بتاعت أسبوع الآلام. يوم الاثنين يوم الجبارة الجبروت. ليه؟ بسرعة. ليه؟ ليه يوم الجبارة؟ ليه الجبروت يوم الاثنين؟ عمل ايه المسيح؟ لعن التينة وعمل ايه تاني؟ وطرد. لعن وطرد. Why was Monday the day of power? Kick out the sellers, right? And the fig tree. No more out of your fig tree and was dead in the moment. الاثنين جبارة والتلات إشارة. كانت إشارة لإيه يوم التلات؟ أنا لسه قايلها. المجيء الثاني وملكوت السماوات. So Tuesday talked about again the heavenly kingdom and the second coming. So it was all symbols and parables towards this meaning. لو الاثنين جبارة والتلات إشارة يبقى الأربع إيه؟ إمارة. مظبوط؟ إمارة جاية من التآمر. يبقى حصل يوم الأربع سهلة إيه؟ وابتدت النهاردة لأن النهاردة إيه؟ ليلة الأربع. صح؟ So Wednesday is the plot. That's when the plot started, and it's actually started tonight, and we just read it as the last sentence. الخميس يبقى خميس إيه؟ مين يعرف يقولها؟ يبقى قولنا جبارة وإشارة وإمارة، يبقى الخميس إيه؟ كفارة. بلاش أنت أشياء. بل الخميس كفارة. So Thursday is the day of the sacrifice, and we all know that. That's why Abunas will be offering incense and starting the very, very, very first communion and holy liturgy and Qudas, right? طب إذا كان كل ده بقى وصلنا لإيه؟ للجمعة، جمعة الإيه؟ الإنكسارة. يبقى الاثنين جبارة والتلات إشارة والأربع إمارة والخميس كفارة والجمعة إنكسارة. Why was Friday a sad, broken day? Because our beloved Jesus was hung on a cross, was crucified, right? لكن يجي السبت، سبت الإيه؟ الاستنارة. مظبوط؟ يبقى سبت النور، سبت الاستنارة. Why was Saturday the day of light? Why was Saturday the day of light? Why? Because all, yes. No, he did not rise from the dead on Saturday. You're ahead of the game. You're going to fast one more day. So why is Saturday istinara light? Anyone knows? Quickly. Bravo عليك. الناس المذاكرة هي. She studied the Bible very well. It is the day when all people thousands of years ago were laid in the hope, على رجاء, in the hope of Jesus coming. This is the day Jesus will go and conquer and get them out of wherever they are, hell, right? لكن 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 الحد بقى يوم الايه اذا كان الاثنين جباره والثلاث اشاره والاربع اماره والخميس كفاره والجمعه انتصاره والسبت استناره يبقى الحد ايه ها لا انتصاره right so it is the resurrection the day of the resurrection okay right next question who's ready okay next question I might pick on certain people right So we did read today, and I'm including both, the morning hours and the evening hours. We did read the parable of the virgins, the 10 virgins. أرينا النهاردة إنجيل العذارة الخمسة والخمسة. أنهي ساعة? Which hour did we read that gospel at? And I'm gonna pick Ahab. الساعة السادسة, okay, on the sixth hour of the night. Okay, so... Let me go back to the sixth hour and go to the, oops, sorry, go to the gospel. I did actually, thank you. So then the kingdom of heaven, okay, I'm going to read fast but focus, all right, because questions are coming. Then the kingdom of heaven shall be likened to 10 virgins who took their lamps, went out to meet the bridegroom. Now 5 of them were wise, 5 were foolish. Those who were foolish took their lamps and took no oil with them. But the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps. But while the bridegroom was delayed, they all slumbered and slept. And at midnight, a cry was heard. Behold, the bridegroom is coming. Go out to meet him. Then all those virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish said to the wise, Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out. But the wise answered, saying, No, lest there should not be enough for us and you. But go rather to those who sell and buy for yourselves. And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came. Those who were ready went in with him to the wedding, and the door was shut. Afterwards, the other virgins came also saying, Lord, Lord, open to us. But he answered and said, Assuredly, I say to you, I do not know you. Watch therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour. مش هقرا بالعربي لأنه كلكم حافظينه بالعربي. Okay. So we have 5 wise and 5 foolish. Anyone disagree with that? We all know that, right? That's the easiest part. That is not the question, sorry. Okay, the question is, ما هي أوجه التشابه بين العشرة الحكيمات والعشرة الجاهلات? I'm sorry. What are the similarities between the 5 wise virgin and the 5 foolish virgin? Okay, well, no. We need to be civilized. Raise your hand. Okay, I have a hand here.
They were all going to the wedding.
All invited to the wedding. Excellent. So they all received an invitation to go to the wedding, right? That's number one. Okay? Did you? Madeleine, you're going to fast another day? Yes. I can't hear you. Both of them have... The same equipment. They have lamps in their hands, right? So they all have the same equipment. What else? No, I'm talking about similarities. I'm not talking about differences yet. All virgins. So they all have the same look. They all have the same build. They all have the same complexion, right? Okay, so they all virgins. They all have the same equipment. And they were all invited to the wedding. What else? Similarities, not differences. Bravo alayki. They all have the intent to meet the bridegroom. They are all waiting. They are all anxiously going to attend the wedding. So they have the same intent. عندهم نفس النية لحضور الفرح. What else? Similarities. Bravo. Who said that? Meg, I don't think Megid, you can say that. Bravo, guys. Excellent. They all faced the same circumstances. Number one, العريس أبطأ. The groom was late. Number two, they all felt heavy and they all slept. وكله اتعرض لنفس الموقف. كلهم مستنين العريس. العريس اتأخر. تعبوا. نعسوا. ناموا. Very scary. Very scary. They look very much alike, correct? I'm not going to ask what are the differences, right? There are two differences, there are nothing more. Two differences. One, as Nuba said, group has oil. The other group does not have oil. And the outcome. The outcome was totally different. البابا شنود الله ينايح نفسه لما بيتكلم على المثل ده عمري ما سمعته بيقول ربنا يرحم ربنا يرحم. In 45 minutes he's explaining this parable. Pope Shenouda said ربنا يرحم, Lord have mercy, like 3 or 4 times while he's saying, and I'm sensing what he's saying. المثل ده صعب جدا 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 ومعزي جدا جدا في نفس الوقت. Only you are contradicting yourself. It's a very tough parable. It's a very unique one and needs a lot of understanding. It is difficult for all of us, yet it's promising for all of us. Why is it difficult? ليه المثل ده من الأمثلة الصعبة؟ المثل ده ما بيتكلمش على أبرار وأشرار. المثل ده ما بيتكلمش على الابن الضال. المثل ده ما بيتكلمش على الدرهم المفقود ولا الخروف المفقود. We are not talking in this parable about bad people and good people. We're not comparing these. We're not comparing the prodigal son who left and took everything and went away and no one can find him for years, spent everything, and when he became totally desperate, okay, let me go back to my dad. I might have a job with the servants there. No. We're not at that level. We're talking about us here. We're talking about all of us. We're talking about servants. We're talking about people who got the invitation. We're talking about people who look alike. We are talking about people who have the same mission. We are talking about people who have the same standards. We are talking about people who have the same equipment. We are talking about the same people who have the same intent and desire. What is الزيت? إيه الزيت? إيه يعني شغلانة الزيت اللي انت عامل لنا دوشة عليها دي? Why is the زيت? Why? Okay, let me just ask regular question. Ladies, you have been using zayt for 50 days and 5 more days to go for zayt. Just tell me natural uses of zayt. Oil. استعمالات الزيت العادية. الزيت بيعمل ايه? بيوجع البطن. بينور. صح. الزيت بينور. Sure. بنستعمله. لو تبص على الشمعة, the candles we have is bunch of zayt together. Okay, what else? Used to cook, صح? It gives taste, right? دسم, مظبوط? يلين. أبونا مخيل, أنا مخلي التحلية في الآخر. So, إحنا في اسمة الابن الوحيد, أبونا بيقول إيه? إذا رأيتني عضوا يابسا, إيه? رطبني بزيت نعمتك. If you find me a very dry person, soften me with the oil of your grace. رطبني بزيت نعمتك. بيلين, بيرطب. Okay, what else? Healing. الزيت بيشفي. ده احنا عندنا سر كامل اسمه ايه? عندنا اسرار كتيرة وعندنا حاجات كتيرة. فالزيت العادي ليه استعمالات كتيرة جدا ومن اقيم الحاجات. ما هو الزيت في المثل ده? Yes, yes, Zahar. I can't hear you. بندهم بالراس, مظبوط. ما دي جاي من التطيب والتليين. بس it's a good point. طب إيه الزيت في المثل ده? ليه الزيت في المثل ده مهم? Why is the زيت here makes a big difference? برافو عليك. So, the answer was acts, الأعمال. الزيت هي الأعمال. I still can get confused because they both were doing good stuff. They both have, again, as I mentioned, great intentions. So actually, even الأعمال might be similar. أنا وإيهاب بنخدم شمامسة إحنا الاثنين. إيهاب might have a different desire than me. I might be liking my Tonya. Like how I look, maybe Ahab is coming to serve the Lord. So there might be a difference. الزيت قداسة البابا شنودة بيقول عليه هو عمل الروح القدس. في تفسيرات كتير قوي للزيت. You can explain it the way you want. The best definition of zayt, of oil in this parable, according to Pope Shenouda, is it is the Holy Spirit inside me. So the difference between these two groups of virgins, one group have everything but were stopped at certain level. One group has everything looking for the next step. What is between here and there? Al-ishtiyaq wal-inshigal. This is the answer. The desire and the longing for a relationship with the Lord. That is the difference between the two groups. There is a group that is doing it as a duty. Got invited, got dressed, I look like a virgin, got my lamp, going, attending, I want to meet the bridegroom. And there is a group that has all of these, and they know. Just let me explain to you traditionally. Traditionally, in the Jewish tradition at that time, 2,000 years ago, it was very well known that the groom might be late for the wedding. Because the tradition says that the family of the bride get the groom the morning of that day. Okay, guys, remember, this is 2,000 years ago. Don't do it today, okay? And they keep bargaining on him. Hey, our daughter is a very precious one. We're not going to give her to you this simple. What are you going to give? And although they have been doing this for a whole year or 2 years, بس حبكت يوم الفرح. So the more demand the day off, because obviously that's the day of pressure. Everybody wants things to move along. Everybody wants smooth forward movement. So they keep bargaining with him until they get the maximum out of him. According to the tradition, this is true. ده مش تفسير. This is true tradition. He might be late literally until midnight, trying to figure out how he's going to finish this and make the family of the bride happy so he can go and get married and get his bride and probably will never see them again. So, knowing all of this, why did the five foolish virgins not think ahead of the game? And that is the point. Baba Shenouda bardo biqul eh? بيقول بين دول وبين دول في كلمة أغلق الباب. بيقول الباب قاعد مفتوح فترة طويلة لداود النبي. داود النبي زنى وكذب وقتل وقدم توبة فظيعة، توبة رائعة، وربنا قبله وأعاده. شاول الطرسوسي عمال يقتل ويهدم وينشر إجرام، ربنا يقبله يعمل معاه لقاء يبقى بولس الرسول. لكن الجماعة دول كان قدامهم الباب مفتوح وما دخلوش وما حاولوش يخشوا وما عملوش المستقبل. So Pope Shenouda explains the concept of the door was open by giving the best example of David. So David, while the door was still open, after committing multiple sins, adultery, lying, killing, he came back and gave a great repentance story. So is Saint Paul, Saul before Saint Paul, and so are many, many other saints. But be very careful and be very aware of the word وَأُغْلِقَ الْبَابِ, and the door was shut. A true story happened about maybe 20 years ago or 30, more than, maybe between 20 and 30 years ago, took place in London. A major robbery happened to a major bank, and one of the robbers took his share of what they stole. And the bank was very near to the train station. So quickly, he jumped into the very first train coming. The train was about to take off and to leave. So he quickly ran and jumped in and left the door behind him open. While he's sitting and collecting himself and panting, obviously running and taking a breath, so the train started speeding. And all of a sudden, boom, the door was shut. And while he's trying to collect this, it kept knocking in his head. The door was shut. The door was shut. The door was closed. The door was shut. When did I hear this? And he remembered years and years ago, his Sunday school teacher giving the parable of the virgins, the five and the five, and stressing on, don't ever allow to hear the word, the door is shut, I do not know you. Very quickly, the very next station, he went down, gave himself to the police, went to prison, and he wrote one of the best repentance stories ever from inside the prison. So القصة دي بتحكي جماعة سرقوا بنك في لندن, واحد منهم بعد ما خد الفلوس طلع على محطة قطر بسرعة عشان يهرب, كان القطر ابتدى يتحرك, ركب ونط في القطر بسرعة, كان القطر لسه يدوبك بيتحرك, ساب الباب وراه مفتوح على بال ما قعد ولم نفسه, الباب كان القطر ابتدى يسرع جدا فالباب اتقفل بعنف وسمع صوت رزعة الباب. احنا عارفين كلنا الموضوع ده, باب بيترزع شوية هوا بيجوا في البيت لو سايب باب مفتوح بيترزع رزعة جامدة جدا, مظبوط؟ رنت في ودانه, امتى اغلق الباب؟ ليه اغلق الباب؟ ايه كلمة اغلق الباب؟ افتكر درس خده في مدرسة الاحد من سنين على المثل ده, وقدم توبة رائعة من جوه السجن, وكتب من كتاب من اعظم كتب في حياة التوبة. فكانت قصة جميلة جدا. The problem in this parable is if we ever think that we have enough, this is the beginning of the end. So the five foolish did not think of the future at all. And the Lord loves the hard workers, loves people who are looking forward to better chances. Allah يحب المجتهدين ويشفع في المثابرين وينظر إلى الناظرين إلى المستقبل. المثل اللي قلته لكم قبل كده كتير وأنا عارف أنكم زهقتوا من سمعه مني, بس هقوله تاني. لو تخيلنا أن العلاقة بيننا وبين ربنا سلم من هنا لفوق, من 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 عتبة رقم صفر للعتبة رقم 100, The Lord would love to see you في العتبة التانية أو التالتة, عمال تتشعبط وتتنطط عايز توصل للرابعة, أحسن من واحد قاعد على العتبة العشرين مدلدل رجليه وبيبص عليك تحت وبيتريق عليك, بص اللي تحت الجدع العبيط اللي تحت ده اللي بيحاول يتنطط, أنا في بص أنا فين, أنا قاعد في العشرين. You all heard me saying this before. So if you are in the slower, smaller step but reaching higher, and this is what Jacob have seen in his dream, right? He did see a ladder connecting heaven to earth, but his ladder was full of angels going up and down. Our ladder, our job is to keep climbing as much as you can. It does not matter you are in step number one or step number 20. Myself included, I consider myself in step number zero. Maybe number less than zero, but I will try and I will do my best to keep climbing to the next step. Way better than someone sitting on the very high level and satisfied with where he is. As hard as this parable is, it also gives equal opportunity for repentance. It tells you that the Lord's doors are open for all of us. The invitation is for everyone. We are living today and the door is still open. ما تديش لنفسك فرصة انك تسمع اغلق الباب لا اعرفكم. Twice حصل صراخ. Twice there was a loud noise. Jesus Christ, when he came in the nativity, there was a very loud noise, but it was a beautiful noise. It was the songs of the nativity, right? Glory be to God in the highest, peace on earth, and a goodwill towards men, right? And everybody's singing, الرعاه, farmers, the angels, everybody's singing. لكن الصوت الثاني, the second voice, وجاء العريس وكان صراخ وأغلق الباب. في جزء دخل وجزء مش هيخش. ربنا يديكم كلكم ان تكونوا في الناحيه دي ونخش كلنا مع بعض. And God bless you all and thank you.